I thought I'd attempt a little video. Now, as you know, I've never done this before, so it could be a complete disaster, so just bear with me. I've been around the garden and collected a few bits. I'm just going to dart off and get them. So, got some lovely spirea that when the leaves first come out, and eventually they'll turn green, but they start off this lovely bronzy, orangey colour. And I thought they'd go really rather well with these fabulous Fritillaria. They're perhaps a little bit straight, actually, but we'll see what we can do with them. And they smell pretty funky. And I've also got quite a lot of narcissus, because they seem to be really, it's been really warm here the last couple of days, and the narcissus was keeling over. And some forsythia, and my first, gosh, I can't get them out, first tulips of the year. Actually, when I picked them just now, they were much more open, so in the sun they're really open, but it's a bit more gloomy in here, so they've closed up. I'm really wishing that my brown sugar tulips would flower just in time for the Fritillaria, because I think they'd look beautiful together. But I think the Fritillaria are also going over in the sun, and so probably they're not going to make it. The brown sugars are still quite tight. And then I chose these hellebores, because they're really beautifully dark, rich. I don't know if you can see, but underneath the crazy hairdos of the Fritz, they've got these dark tops. I'm always trying to find bits that kind of go together, and they seemed to go rather well. Whether that will actually work in an arrangement, well, we'll find out anyway. Going to move this to one side. Actually quite heavy. So in here I have got a frog, and I've very stupidly already put the water in, so I can't show you. But you know, one of those bed of nails things. And I think because these boys are so big, I'll put them in first. And clearly, that's quite big for that bowl, so I'm going to chop it down. I'll keep trying to remember to turn the bowl around to show you what I'm doing. I think I'm going to have to take off some of these leaves. It might be too much in the arrangement. What I'm looking for is to just make some shapes, really. I never really know how things are going to work out until you start making, or in fact, until you get to the end. This one, rather unfortunately, is covered in pigeon poo. I will be washing my hands afterwards. It's quite handy having this in front of me. I can see what I'm doing there. Do I want to go that high? I don't believe in proportion with the bowl, the vessel. I kind of think the vessel's neither here nor there. So I would be happy to go that high. It just feels a bit bold. I might take it down lower, actually. Seems that generally flowers when I use in the hymns. Very rarely hers. He's not she's. No idea why. This one hasn't escaped the pigeon poo either. I don't know, I could have it going a little bit. You know what, why not? We're in a strange new world. Let's just do it anyway. Goodness, these smell. Really, really do smell quite strong. That's just too big. That's not. This really is going to be an interesting design. Okay, so this is sort of what I'm seeing. See if we can do anything with this. So I think I'll put this in next. This is where I end up going silent. This. If I'm home alone, very quietly, no music, just the blank thoughts in my head, and it really is blank. So I'm just doing a little bit of editing of the more twiggy bits. I haven't got anything on. Shape, isn't it? I'm always trying to look at the shapes. In you go. Doesn't seem to want to go there. Let's see if we can tuck it in through here. In an ideal world, I don't want anything touching each other. I might have to edit this a bit more. There we go, that's better. Not so bulky, and I've got some more little bits for filling in later. Shoot, see where that goes. See that shape? I'm really up upset if I had to cut that down. Let's see. Maybe I can get it to twist up this stem. Maybe I can't. Power of persuasion. Very hard not to get his messes in on the air, but I can't see that lasting. So you're seeing the far side. This is the front side. Far too big for the screen. Hold your bow, Bridge. Hold the bow. There we go. Final little piece. You see how tempted I am to stuff that in? I'm not going to, I'm going to save it. So now I'm going to try and accent it with some forsythia. Woody stems, I give them a fresh cut and then I cut up the stem as well. Just seems to help them keep hydrated. It's always quite interesting just seeing where these designs end up. There is no plan. There's no right or wrong. There are no rules. Anything can happen. It's such an old pin frog. In fact, I got it from a second-hand shop. Some of the spines are a little bent over. I do like that piece if it's in the wrong place. Sometimes you just know when something's not quite right, inexplicably. See, this is the beauty of using a pin frog. Restricted on how many times you can change your mind. Because I haven't put chicken wire in, it's just the pin frog. It almost looks like a little pool of water, so I don't have to completely fill the bowl up, which is, well, actually, even if it's chicken wire, I don't mind anybody seeing that either. But it just looks like a little pond of things growing out of it, so I don't need to fill it up and over clutter it. Work. Is it starting to close up? I'll see if I can swing it to open up again, like it was in the sun. Oh no, now my tongue's rumbling. Just had lunch with Hetty on the bench outside in the sunshine. Completely out of my comfort zone with this colour combination, but I'm going with what the garden's giving me. My local wholesaler sent an email today saying that sadly they're closing as of this Friday because of the situation we find ourselves in. So although I don't use them very often, I'm so grateful that I've got my garden flowers, even if they're not necessarily always the colours I'd want. Enjoying this, and now I've opened up the tulips again. What I haven't noticed outside in the full sun is just how dark those centres are, which again is just like the tops of the Fritillaria. How had I not noticed that? I like the shape of that. That's what I was doing. I don't even know if those beautiful dark frets will make it to this particular party. Might be too heavy. One going backwards. Forwards to you, backwards to me. As you can see, through the arrangement to the back. Now, of course, these tulips over the next couple of days are really going to move and grow, basically do their own thing. So whatever I do with them now, that will not be how they look in a few days' time. Or even this evening. This is really looking quite like my garden, I have to say. Look at these darling little things. Little windmills. Smell delicious. No idea what they're called. I did buy them and I did put them in. I'm hopeless at remembering the names of things. Absolutely hopeless. I do like things to sit with a friend in the garden. They generally have a little friend that they're with. So I like to do that in my arrangements as well. Have you noticed there are a beautiful lot of pollen beetles about already? Only one of these is opened at the moment. Again, it smells delicious. Unfortunately, he is going in on his own. Let's pop him down there. These beautiful little pale ones, we inherited in the garden we moved here, I don't know, 20 years ago. These are already here. I mean, they've multiplied since then, I think. Pretty sure they have. They have. No idea what they are, but they're lovely, lovely, soft colour. Come here, little guy. Let's just pop it I want you to be even lower. Don't want any spoiling at the back of that tulip. So I need something here, and I think it's probably going to be probably another tulip. For the tone, they should smell, but they don't. Do you know what this one is? Thalia, however you might say it. Oh my goodness. One of my absolute favourites. Sometimes you just know you need to stop or go and have a cup of tea, one thing or the other. So, there we go. What do you think? It's a crazy little display of everything that's just